Hi, welcome to one more video on compensation. So in this we'll see a fourth example of designing a lead compensator. So we have a client having a transfer function given by s into this is 4 by s into 2 plus s, and first condition is that we are supposed to consider dfs as k, and then we need to find the value of k such that velocity error constant kv is equal to 20, and with the value of k that we want to find for part A, so we have to find out what is the phase margin. Then we need to design a lead compensator, phase lead compensator, so that the phase margin is greater than 50 degrees. So let us proceed with this problem. Since we are considering dfs as k and the velocity error constant required is 20, so using this equation we can find out the value of k as 10. So with the value of k as 10, we can actually find out what is the magnitude equation for the entire transfer function with k as 10. So it comes out to be 40 by s into 2 plus s, so which we're going to have a gain cross of frequency of 6.16 radian per second, the corresponding phase equation, and the phase at omega gc happens to be minus 162 degree. So which will result in a phase margin of 18 degree. Of course, the gain margin happens to be infinite. We will have a look at this phase margin in the later stage. So let us proceed with the compensation. Since we want to have a compensation of 50 degree using this phase network. So one second, let me just clarify whether it is 40 degree. I think it is 40 degree. Okay, here it is. We need to have 50 degree. So let me just okay, this is actually before compensation it is how much we have before compensation, we have hardly 18 degree, so this need to be changed to 18 degree. The phase shift of course the introduction of phase lead network will also introduce some phase shift into the will also introduce the shifting of gain cross of frequency, which will reduce the phase margin of the system, so that so since we require a 50 degree phase margin, we already have 18 degree, another 32 degree has to be provided. So along with this 32 degree, we will also consider another 6 degree, which is due to the shifting of this gain cross of frequency because of the introduction of this DFS. So we are looking at introduction of a maximum phase of 38 degree. So corresponding to this, we are going to have the alpha as 0.24. So with this 0.24, we are coming to the very important stage of the design. So considering only the magnitude part of the phase lead network, so at this particular phase which is resulting in 38 degree, so at this frequency which results in 38 degree phase shift, we are going to have a magnitude of 6.2 dB. So whatever the frequency of zero on the pole, so this will result in a magnitude of 6.2 dB, and in terms of ratio it will be 2.04. So we have to ensure that okay, this 6.2 dB whatever we have in has to be nullified in such a way that the omega gc happens to be that new frequency where the magnitude of the GFS should be exactly negative of that 6.2. Now you are looking at a frequency which corresponds to minus 6.2 dB, so that the new cutoff frequency will want to have exactly the frequency corresponding to maximum phase shift. So that is coming out to be 9 radian per second. So now with omega c as the frequency at which we want to have maximum phase shift and alpha as 0.24, we can actually locate the zeros and poles of the phase lead network, which happens to be at 4.41 radian per second and 18.4 using these equations, because we know omega c and alpha. So being known the values of omega c and alpha, so knowing the zero and the pole position, we will get the overall transfer function of the system in the time constraint form as 20 divided 20 into the location of the zero, and then we have the system pole here. This is again the system pole, and this happens to be the pole corresponding to the phase lead network. So now to verify whether this will going to satisfy the KV of 20 or not, so use this open loop transfer function of the compensated system and use it in this equation. So if you apply this limit of S into 0 and S into DFS into GFS, so this comes out to be 20. This is what is required also in our when we started the problem. It is also verified that using equations, the omega GC will be now 9 radian per second. So for this particular transfer function, of course it has got zeros 10 at minus 4.41, and it has got 3 poles, one at origin, one at minus 2, other is at minus 18.4, and the system gain here is 20, and this will result in a phase margin of 50.4 degree, so which is more than the required phase margin of 50 degree. And of course the gain margin in this case is infinity because we have effectively only 2 poles here, because this phase wise this will cancel with this. So omega PC, since it is infinity, we want to have the gain margin also as infinity. So let us go to 20 sim and try to verify 3 parameters, that is without compensation how much is the phase margin, with compensation how the phase margin increases to 50.4, and we'll also see what is the impact of adding the phase lead network, how much is the magnitude that it is going to introduce, which we saw it as 6.2 dB. We'll see these 3 parameters. Okay, let us observe the okay, you can see we have, this is for that uncompensated system. If you can see here, we have, this is the if I can just slightly adjust this, so this is 40 divided by S into 2 plus S. This is in the pole zero form. The root locus gain is 40. You can see the root locus gain is 40. We have got the poles at origin and minus 2. You can see poles are at origin and minus 2. So if you plot the border plot of that, so border plot of that looks like this here. You can see this happens to be a 0 dB line corresponding to omega GC 6.16, which is over here. You can see the corresponding phase margin is 17.96 degrees, which is equal to 18 degrees here. So this is what is the phase margin and omega GC for an uncompensated system having a transfer function which is given over here as, this is the transfer function. So let us go to the compensated system which has got two more poles, one more pole and a zero. There is a pole at minus 18.4 and a zero at minus 4.4 with the system gain depending as 20. Let us see what is the improvement in the phase margin. So phase margin should increase to 50.4 as per this, and then omega GC should be 9 radian per second. We will see that. So let me go here and then add a pole at minus 18.4. This is added, and then we will also add a zero at, we'll add a zero at minus 4.41. So now this is added. If you can see now, so the system gain, let us go back and see, system gain should be 20. Let me edit this system gain to 20 here. The system gain should be now, so let me edit this system gain as 20. Now this is done. We will see what is the border plot of that. So border plot of this, if you can see here, this happens to be having a phase margin of 50.43, and you can see the omega GC is 8.9. so theoretically we are getting this as 9 and this as almost 51 degrees. So that's what is the theoretical value we got. You can see it is 50.4 and this omega GC is almost 9 radian per second. So and then we will also see what is the phase introduced by the phase lead network. We will see that in a moment. So let me just go back to this and then take out these two poles of the system. I'll remove this and I'll remove this also. Let me have only the pole and zero of the composite network. Let me have the gain as hardly 1. Now if I apply this and try to see what is the border plot of this, I'm supposed to get at around 9 radian per second, it should be minus, okay, 6.2. So this is what is 6.2 we are looking at. So let me see here. You can see at a frequency equal to close to 9 radian per second. We are looking at this is x value 9 radian per second. See, close to 9 radian per second, we have 6.2 as the magnitude offered by the feedback, the phase lead network. And this need to be compensated by that plant transfer function.